Hello and welcome to a new series, The Walking Dead Michonne Story. I almost forgot this was even a thing, I won't lie. I guess this is supposed to detail before she meets Rick, I'm guessing. Because I don't remember these people from the TV show, but I haven't really watched all of it. I've pretty much more seen the beginning and the end, and a little bit of the prison. That's pretty much it. But I don't have any ideas or knowledge of this. I think I seen like a teeny bit. Like that's how much. Like just a teeny bit. Probably like almost a minute. So I don't really know what to expect in this. I know a lot more about the last one, but I don't even know much about that one either. So
I left we're getting so close many to the people end. That I loved behind.
Oh, we're doing like a narration type deal. I wonder if she's going to sound the same as she does in the TV show.
I can hardly remember them all.
Oh, the hair.
But there are two. Just two that I can never forget.
Are those her kids?
I thought I was done with them. But they're not done with me.
Sorry, it feels kind of somewhat out of place. What the? I'm sorry, she just comes in with a freaking samurai sword. Thing is, I know she'll live. That's the annoying thing. In the end of this. Driving a deeper kill them? That don't make no sense. That one doesn't even look like it's trying. He gets right to his shoulder. Nope, into the fire. So you seriously telling me you had an open fire in your house? Hey, Michonne must have been rich and irresponsible. That sounds like an accident waiting to happen. Pretty good combat so far, even though it looks a bit wild. Dang, you need to sharpen your sword. Like a dead corpse. That shouldn't be so hard to cut. Don't throw it away! So where did she get her sword? Because she was just straight up using a machete earlier. You gotta stomp the head. Oh. Oh wow. That has to hurt. But also, if there's a fire going on, at least in reality, then that means people have to be nearby. Zombies don't just start a fire. Where you keep your bullets?
Some days I envy the dead.
No. I wonder if it's more based off in the comics. Or at least close enough in the comics, so you can actually have a choice. Also, I wonder if you even really did have a choice in that. Would he just stop you or something? It'd be kind of weird if she just actually did.
Rashid, come in. Over. Vanessa! You there? God damn it.
Hey, Pete.
Michonne. What are you doing up? Your shift isn't for another hour.
Couldn't sleep.
Having those nightmares again. You holding up okay? Don't worry about you. You're not the easiest to read.
I honestly don't know.
This stuff you're dealing with, it's not gonna go away overnight. Just please tell me if, you know, if it gets as bad as it did.
I just need to keep busy.
Oak! Oak!
What?
Get down here, Michonne's taking your shift.
2 minutes!
I still haven't heard from Rashid or Vanessa. It's not like those guys to be in a contact for this long. We trade every time I come through. Same spot. Everything's just gone. Just doesn't make sense. Their boat is always anchored right on the dock.
Vanessa! Rashid, come in!
They might have moved on. Left the area.
Not without telling us. They'd have left a message behind or something. They wouldn't just disappear.
Maybe we can pass by again on our way back.
Listen. You hear it? You hear it, right? It sounds like a woman's voice.
Vanessa, that you?
I hear static.
No, it's more than just static.
Hey.
Michonne? Again with the shortwave?
I'm not just giving up. This bay was full of boats just a year ago. They went somewhere.
If they left, it was probably for good reason.
Then I want to know why. Hello? Hello? Can you hear me? Hello?
That time I heard something.
You heard it that time, right? She said help.
I don't know, Pete. Didn't sound like Vanessa.
But it's someone. She might know what happened here.
No, damn it! We're losing the signal.
Look, if we don't start caring about the people that are out there, we're no better than the damn walkers.
All we'll find out there is trouble, Pete.
I mean it. What's the point in just surviving? We gotta do better than that.
All right, so let's help her.
At least someone gets it.
You're the only one on this boat that even comes close to understanding. Not Berto, not Sadiq, especially not fucking Oak. You know there are people worth helping. Take over from me, okay?
I hate the choice because I would morally choose, like, you can't, you know, not all people can get help. You know, you can't do everything. All that just sounds bad. Why does it keep...
Anything?
I heard her. Barely.
I knew it!
Oh, this is a bad idea, Pete. You want to find more people. You're forgetting what people are like.
What is she doing?
What the f- Oh, bloody hell!
Who's that? Can't see a damn thing!
Everyone okay? Berto! Sadiq!
You guys better get up here!
What do we hit?
Hell if I know! I can't see a damn thing!
Berto! Hold the wheel steady! Take in those sails, now! Sadiq! Get down!
Are you all right? Thanks for the save.
Jesus!
Oh, get the jib under control!
Damn shortwave.
You just had to take us in close, right into a fucking rock!
Hey, I've been sailing these waters for years. There aren't any rocks here.
Well then what the hell was that?
Something else.
You said it yourself. Something's going on around here.
This place isn't safe anymore, Pete. Your friends are gone, and whatever scared them off is gonna find us next. I told you this was a bad idea.
Holy
You're just being paranoid.
It's not paranoia if you're right.
You all need to calm down. We don't know anything yet.
She's right. Panicking about it won't make us any less stuck.
That girl on the shortwave. What if she's part of it?
Guys, pull it together. Oak, Sadiq, get those sails tied down. Once we've checked for damage, we can haul off. Ease our way out. Go on.
Michonne,
what exactly did she say?
She said, Mob Jack. I couldn't make out more than that.
Michonne, take these. See if you can figure out what we got stuck on.
Just see if we're close to anything. I mean, I need to know what our options are.
We just need to get ourselves moving again, for all our sakes.
Jeez.
Pete.
Whatever we ran into, the goddamn number on the boat. Damn.
Not much to see out there.
Wait, could I have looked over the boat like I thought I was able to do? No.
It's too dark to see much of anything. Hey, Pete. Figured out what we're stuck on.
Damn. At least it's not Rashid's boat.
Hey, Michonne. Hope no one's still on that boat. I don't want to die like that. Sorry. I just seen a lot of bad shit go down. I don't want to see this fall apart. You know? I've seen better places than this get torn to shreds.
You're not the only one.
I shouldn't let him see me slacking off like this.
Hey, Michonne, we could use a hand here.
Maybe gonna bleed the wind out of this sail.
I stand by what I said. Pete isn't cautious enough.
He's just an optimist.
You call it what you like, but we shouldn't be trying to find people. We should be staying the hell away from them. Look where we are. You think this is an accident? Damn wind.
You're saying this is a trap?
People do anything to survive these days. And to get their hands on a boat like this...
Oh, you think you got it all figured out, don't you?
Thanks. We can think of it here.
Alright. I'm gonna stop it here for now, so I hope you enjoyed... Ooh, I like the menu. I hope you enjoyed this episode like I did, and I hope to see you next time. Bye-bye!